also attend, which we'll get an up-to-date information about where we're at. There's a further meeting in the reins, I think it's the 21st of March, with the Chief Constable, Police Crime Commissioner, Chief Fire Officer, Chief of the Authority, and also with the Chief Fire Officer and the PCC and Chief Constable for Cheshire. Because the problem that exists at the moment is because the footprint for the Kingside for the fire is the Merseyside footprint. The Liverpool City region and the devolution deal includes Halton, local business. The problem is at the moment is because that is organisations are run by Cheshire Fire and Rescue Service, and obviously Cheshire PCC. There's an issue with the governments and a few of the technical and legislative issues that need to be gone. So there's going to be a round the table meeting, which I think is going to be some frank exchanges about where we're going, what's the proposals, what's the options, where can we go. And we need to do this in order to explore the next tranche of devolved powers to the Liverpool City region, which I would expect that the fire and police and maybe other services might be involved with prior to the election, which will be in 2020. So those negotiations are going to be ongoing. Then we'll have a look and explore how the new authority or how the governance arrangements will look by that time, whether it be in 2019 or 2020, but in the coming future, we will explore what the new governance arrangements will be. The other reason that it was held back is because there's some issues of concern for me personally about what's going on in the Greater Manchester area, with the governance arrangements there and the lines of responsibility and accountability, which has caused me some great concern. And I think the lessons that we should learn from that, we could take to our discussions, what we have in the next coming weeks. There's also different models to be explored. The model in Greater Manchester might be the one that would be best fit for us. There's another one being explored, a different one in the West Midlands, that might be something that we might look at, might explore, might adopt. And there's another model that's getting looked at for London and Greater London. So we have to make sure that for whatever government arrangements we adopt for the future is fit for purpose. And it's going to be, hopefully it will include some savings to the authority. And that also has to look at what the future government arrangements and the costs associated with that. So that's where we're at. The working party that we set up will need once further information is known so that we can take it forward and the next steps. And will there be calls to future meetings of the authority, and any decisions that need to be made will be made at that juncture.
Thank you, if Jane attended our group meetings like that, as you are the Labour PCC, and that'd be because that's the fact that the Iron Glover's doors, and that's the best way to do it.
Any other comments? Otherwise, we'll go to the votes on the working resolution. Okay, all those in favour of the voting resolution, please show. Okay. Now, I need to ask, because it's anybody against? No? Okay. Thank you very much. That's unanimous by all parties, which is very good. So thank you all for that, and thank you for our colleagues. And I hope that as we go forward in the future, we can work together to resolve any issues that might arise on the conversation. Okay, right, thank you. We go on to the next item now. It's item 6, which is the structural firefighter PPE and technical rescue jackets.
Thank you, Chair. Members, the purpose of this report is to refold. Firstly, it's to advise members that the existing contract for structural firefighting PPE is due to expire. Therefore, we need to re-tender for a new contract, the value of which will exceed £250,000 and will therefore require member approval. Secondly, it's to advise members of the current pooled stock arrangement for the issue of personal protective equipment and to seek approval to revert back to an individual issue. Thirdly, it's to seek member approval for the procurement of technical rescue jackets in addition to structural firefighting PPE ensemble. Some members are aware a PPE ensemble consists of a fire tunic and over trousers, so helmets, boots, gloves and balaclavas are issued individually to firefighters, whereas as it stands currently, the tunics and the over trousers form part of a pooled stock. So the way that operates is, each station currently holds a stock of 1.6 fire tunics and over trousers per firefighter. Pooled stock was introduced some years ago as efficiency saving. When a firefighter needs to replace a tunic and or their over trousers for cleaning or repair, they draw a replacement garment from the station stock. As you'd appreciate, on occasion there's been sizing issues which have resulted in firefighters wearing ill-fitting PPE. This issue's been particularly problematic for women firefighters, as up until now suitable sizing standards for men and women have not been available, would you believe? As you'd appreciate, that is something that we absolutely want to avoid. The intention is therefore to revert back to issuing two sets of individual PPE to every firefighter, which will alleviate this issue, albeit there is an increased cost for the authority. In order to minimise the cost, new PPE will be worn in conjunction with existing PPE until the existing PPE is retired from service, which is set out in paragraph 6 and 7 on pages 168. The estimated additional cost to set out the table, which is at paragraph 9, that's also 168. It's anticipated that these additional costs can be contained within the revenue budget. The proposal to issue two technical rescue jackets is set out in paragraphs 10 and 11 on page 169. Structural firefighting PPE is designed for structural firefighting, as you probably appreciate, members. Therefore, it's very bulky. It needs to be because of the requirement for thermal protection. Structural firefighting is not designed for use at technical rescue incidents, such as road traffic collisions, water rescues, mine rescues, and so forth. It's therefore my recommendation that our crews are issued with technical rescue jackets to increase their comfort levels and their dexterity when we're attending technical rescue incidents. The overall financial implications for both proposals are set out in paragraphs 19 and 20, which is on page 170. In essence, the procurement cost to uplift the PPE provision from the pooled stock to individual issue and for the issue of technical rescue jackets will be met from existing budgets. I will pause at that point, Chair, to take any questions members may have.
Any questions, comments? No? We're happy to approve the
recommendation.
Thank you. Item 7, which is the National Framework on Fire Rescue Service Inspection Consultation.
Thanks, Chair. The purpose of this report is to advise members of the consultation process undertaken over the draft Fire Rescue Service National Framework and the Fire Rescue Service Inspection Framework and the Field Authority responses to both. The background of the national framework set out in paragraphs 3 to 5 on pages 173 to 175. The requirement on the government to produce a Fire Rescue Service national framework is set out within the Fire Rescue Service Act 2004. The proposed objectives for fire rescue authorities set out within the framework are listed at paragraph 5 in the covering report, which is on page 174. Consultation response submitted to government on behalf of the authority is appended to the covering report at pages 179 to 218, but specifically it is the narrative contained within the table on page 217 that makes up our substantive response. The background of the Fire and Rescue Service inspection framework set out in paragraph 6 to 7, which is on pages 175 to 177. The graded judgments that will arise from the inspections are listed at paragraph 13, and they are outstanding, good, requires improvement and inadequate. The inspections are due to commence in the summer with 45 fire rescue services in England divided up into three tranches of 15 each. The authority is scheduled to be inspected in the second tranche, which is scheduled for autumn winter 2018. The consultation response submitted to government on behalf of the old party is appended to the covering report at pages 219 through 240, with the specific narrative contained in the table on pages 237 through to 239. I'll pause at that point here to take any questions that members might have.
Any questions, Matt? Comments? I'm happy with the recommendation.
Tremendous legacy which you take. It's a shame and a sad day for this authority, for politics in Liverpool particularly, politics in Merseyside, that you've made the decision that you have. You can be absolutely certain that every one of us, not just here today, but going back and back and back, has found working with you, Chairman, a pleasure and a privilege, and we all wish you absolutely every best of luck in whatever, and I know you will turn your hand, and whatever you turn your hand to, it will be a great success, and we all know that you have the best interests of the people of this city and of this county at your heart. Thank you for all you've done, and thank you for all you will do.
Policy is a lot different than what it was now. Me and Dave were treated like the scabby after the Labour group then. And he's one of the nicest fellas I've ever worked with in the Labour group in Liverpool. And one of the very few gentlemen within the Labour group of Liverpool. And even through the Metro May campaign, we had different our allegiances were to different people. But we were determined not to fall out over that, and we respected each other's views and opinions because our friendship was more important than politics. I think a lot of people need to realise that when they're doing dirty deals behind people's back in politics, that if you make a good friend, if you don't do dirty deals, friendship is more important than politics. So, you're on our little gang, and we do go for the drink, and that continued when I pleaded with you and begged him only a couple of days ago, wasn't it? Last week, maybe, to reconsider. But there's nothing to say you can't come back. And there's nothing to say that you might not want to come back. But I wish you and your partner, Peter Clark, all the best. You're a lovely couple, and as I say, you're one of the nicest fellas I've ever had the privilege to meet in the whole of my working life, and I've worked since I was 15, so I wish you all the best.
Yeah, thanks. I know this is highly irregular, so I won't take up too much of your time. Dave, look, you've worked with the FBU in campaigning for emergency health fire service over a number of years, as has already been said. I just want to put on our record our thanks for that. Also, look, as a Labour Party member myself, I'm sorry to see that you're not standing as a councillor. I speak for the FBU when I thank you for the work you've done here, and I'm sorry to see you leaving the authority, and I wish you all the best on behalf of the FBU and personally for anything that you decide to do in the future, and you get our full support should you need it. Thanks. Yeah.
Yeah, thanks, Jill. I wasn't going to speak, but I want to endorse everything that everybody said about you as a person. I've only known you for less than 2 years, Dave, but when I came on the Fire Authority, you had been a great support to me from day one, and there's been a number of times I've been sending you emails at midnight and stuff like that. You've always come back to me, you've always given me good constructive advice. I really appreciate that. You are a fantastic person. I'm gutted today to find out that you're not standing. And I'm particularly gutted, I'm not going to go into details now, at what I understand are the circumstances behind that. It is a sad day all round, but I wish you the very, very best of luck, Dave. You've been absolutely brilliant, been a brilliant chair. I totally respect the work you've done, and you've been fantastic to me, and I want to place on record my personal thanks to you for everything you've done for me, as well as the Fire Authority. Best of luck, whatever you do in the future. Thanks, Dave.
Again, I'd like to echo what everyone said, and for me and on behalf of Nosy as well, that I've only been here a few years, and you know, you're really great to get on with, and you've helped and supported me a lot, so thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I have to go to the chamber, probably. Got some late.